Morning, friends. Last class up to 39 we have seen. Next 40. A wire of length L and mass m on two vertical rails joined by the resistance R shown in the figure. There is a uniform magnetic field B perpendicular to the frame. The terminal speed of the wire as it falls under the gravity.
Terminal speed means it moves with a constant velocity without acceleration. Already you have studied in first week. This is the situation. It's falling down with the velocity V. Already I mentioned force will act up. Electromagnetic force. Clear? So when these two forces balance and also Mg acts downwards. When these two forces balances, it moves with constant velocity. Acceleration will be zero. Okay? Clear? This force, what is the force formula? This is B square, L square, V by R. Right? This is balanced with Mg. They are asking V. V is equal to Mg R by B square, L square, V. Sorry. That's all. Mg R by B square, L square. Okay, F is the magnetic force, Mg is the gravity force. When these two forces balanced, net force is zero. Net force is zero means acceleration zero. Acceleration zero means it's moving with constant velocity. There are two options. We can say acceleration zero means body may rest or it may move with constant velocity. So next 41.
Consider the situation as shown in figure. The resistance of the each rod is R. The current in the circuit is V1 greater than V2.
This is one rod moving with velocity V1. Second rod velocity V2. Magnetic field coming out of the board. Okay, then we need to find EMF. This is already length mentioned and length mentioned. So we first this thing is E1. E1 is equal to BL V1. E2 is equal to BL V2. Clear? But they are asking current in this circuit. So we need to find which terminal has positive, which terminal is negative. Then how do we decide? F is equal to Q into V cross B. Q is negative, so minus. Because electron moving down means minus J, field is coming out, so K, so minus J cross K, I, J, K, J cross K is what, I, so minus I, minus is I, so this side negative, this side negative, so, right, like this, it has internal resistance, R and it has internal resistance R. Clear? So this is what E1, this is what E2. Then how do you write? Follow the Kirchhoff rule. This is, we are leaving second terminal, so minus E1 and going like this. So, clear? E1 and next, if it is current which is dominates here, how do we say V1 greater than V2? V1 greater than V2 means this EMF is more. This EMF is more means current moves. We are moving in the direction, current also moving in the same direction. So I into R, this is also minus I into R, leaving positive terminal plus E1 is equal to 0. Then they are asking current. So this is 2IR is equal to what is that? E1 minus E2. Then I is equal to E1 minus E2 by 2R. Okay, E1, E2 substitute there. What is E1? Then I is equal to what is E1? B L V1 minus V L V2 by 2 R. They mentioned internal resistance capital R smaller. So in the options they have given capital R. So this is the correct option. What? Which is I is equal to V L is common. V1 minus V2 by 2 R. See here in the circuit E1 is dominating because what did they mention? V1 greater than V2. V1 greater than V2 means EMF E1 is dominating. So then current enters into this, leaves, and current comes to this terminal. Right? So E1 is dominating. That's why I am taking this one. E1 first. Clear? And now check the option. Which is 41. They given 2. So B L V1 minus V2 by 2 R. They given capital R, but in the question they mentioned a small R. So 42 now. Two equal elliptical rings A and B moving opposite direction with a velocity 2V and V respectively on the conducting surface S. There is a uniform magnetic field magnitude B perpendicular to the plane of the ring. The potential difference highest point of the two rings. This is conducting surface. One ring is like this. This moves in this direction. And another ring is like this. This is moving in this direction. Okay? This they mention as L. And this they mention as 2L. Clear? Now what they are asking, the potential difference between two highest points. This they mention Y and X. They are asking Y minus X. Okay, or VY minus VX. Okay, magnetic field is moving into the board. Okay, now how this EMF acts, that we need to decide. Clear? Moving in, this EMF, EMF develop along the diameter for a ring. Okay, this direction, how do we decide? Electron direction minus which direction it is going? Negative direction. So minus I cross minus K, because field going in, minus into minus plus I cross K. I cross K is minus J, right? Minus of minus J. This is plus J. Plus J means upper end act negative, lower end act positive. Next, this one. Magnetic field same, but velocity direction change. Simply how do we write? Only polarity changes. Upper end positive, lower end is negative. Clear? Now start here. Vy. Leaving negative terminal. So minus E1. This you take in E1. Clear? This is conducting. We are leaving positive terminal. Plus E2 is equal to Vx. Clear? So this will be like this circuit. X, this is Y, and this is X. If they mention internal resistance, that's also comes into play. Then Vy minus Vx. This will be, how do you write? E1 minus E2. Am I correct? Vy, it's a leaving positive terminal. So I written negative, this is plus. This is also leaving positive terminal. So plus only. So this will be, what do you get? Total minus, so minus. So this we can write Vx minus Vy is equal to E1 plus E2. E1 need to write down. What is E1? E1 is equal to 2 BLV, V into 2L into V. Right? Now this is with moving with 2V. E2. E2 is equal to what? This one E2. E2 how do we write? BLV. V same. L length is L with 2V. So total substitute there. E1 plus E2. 2BLV, 2BLV. This is 4BLV. It is 4BLV. 42. 42 given 2. 42 given 2. 2V, we got 4BL and they given 42 is 4 correct. 42 is 4, 4 BLV. 42 is correct, 4 minutes. Understand? So this acts like a EMF, like this battery, of course cell, actually rod, but this terminals, how do we decide? Using this one, and alternate circuit have run. So we what the Kirchhoff's rules follow, we got this equation clear. And next we will go for 43. Consider the situation as shown in the figure. A conducting rod of length 3 meter, resistance 1 ohm, is moving with a velocity 2 meter per second towards the right in a perpendicular uniform magnetic field phi tesla. Current flowing through the rod is, okay, they are asking I. What do you do? EMF we will get. EMF is equal to what? BLV. BLV means what? What is B here? 5, length is 3, velocity is 2. Yes? So 30 volts. And find the net for R effective, means effective resistance. 212, which combination? 212. Sorry, 412 is parallel combination. So the figure is given like this. 4 and 12 parallel combination. So this is 4 into 12 by 4 plus 12. So 4 into 12 by 16. 4 ones, 4 fours. This is 3 ohm. This side is what is the 3 ohm. Okay. Next, this side the given circuit like this. Am I correct or not? Now, this satisfies Kirchhoff's Western network. For this is 4, 2, 16, 10. Satisfies? 4 by 2, 10 by 16 is same, not same. So again, this find out effective resistance that you will get, let us say, R that, R. Do it that, I am giving the key. This is 3 ohm. This has internal resistance smaller. R and R, which combination? Parallel combination. So I is equal to E by R and 3, which combination? Parallel combination. So 3R by 3 plus R into smaller. Already EMF we calculated 30. And R given, internal resistance of the rod given, 1 ohm. This is equal to 1 ohm. This you find out. These two are in series, these two are in series, again these three are parallel. 2 and 10, 12, 4 and 16, 20, 28, 12 are in parallel combination. Right? Understand? So that is R. This R and 3 parallel combination. So 3R by 3 plus R. Plus total resistance with in series. This we can write. Suppose I am alternate diagram and drawing here. This is R, this is 3 ohm, and here it is a battery. Clear? Battery has internal resistance smaller. Like that. Okay? So you do it, you will get the answer. 44. Consider the situation as shown in figure. The rod of mass M is given a velocity V0 towards right. The total heat produced in the resistance R is 44. Okay, there is a figure given. Moving with the velocity V0, mass is M. Total heat produced by the resistance R is given. Then what do you do? Follow. Then what you will do? You will follow the current electricity formula, I square RT. Okay, there is a question. In the options, there is no R, there is no I square, there is no T. What did they give? Just they give a kinetic energy expression. What does that mean? Very simple. Consider the situation shown in the figure. The rod of mass M is given velocity V0 towards right. Which energy is the rod? Kinetic energy. That kinetic energy converted to heat. So, heat is equal to kinetic energy. According to law of conservation of energy, heat is what? Energy. This is converted to kinetic energy. Then this is half m not heat converted to kinetic energy. Kinetic energy converted to heat. That's all.
Don't go this again EMF,
BLV, that you don't substitute here. Some questions we need to think logically. So this is that kind of question.
Next 45. A conducting rod is moving with a constant velocity V on two horizontal rails as shown in figure. This arrangement is perpendicular to magnetic field. If the speed of the rod is made 4 times, the rate of heat dissipated will be. It's related to this question. When V naught is there, heat is H. Now V naught is equal to how many times it will be? 4 times. Then heat will be H is equal to KE. This will be half M. 4 V naught square means 16 V naught square. This is new heat. This I can write 16 into half M V naught square. This is what? When the rod moves with V naught velocity, this is the heat. Now this is the when rod moves with velocity 4 V naught. Then this how do we write? 16 H. H dash is equal to 16 H. How many times increased? 16 times.
Next 46. A conducting rod AB of length L is equal to 2 meter is moving with a uniform speed B is equal to 5 meter per second in a uniform magnetic field 5 Tesla directed into paper. A capacity 4 microfarad is connected as shown in figure. Then the charge on capacitor. It's all related one. This is 45. Next 46. Now what is the charge formula? Capacitor C, potential V, charge Q is equal to C. Here V means what? Induced EMF. So Q is equal to C into E. E is equal to what? V, L, V. Who is producing induced EMF? Where the induced EMF produced? Where the induced EMF developing? In the rod. That formula is BLV. So instead of V, write this one. BLV. Substitute all values. What is C? 4 microfarad. So 4 into 10 power minus 6. B, 5 Tesla. Length 2 meter. Velocity. What is the velocity? 5 meter per second. Right? Yeah, 5 meters. Then 5 into 5, 25. 25 into 2, 50. 50 into 4, 200. Into 10 power minus 6 coulomb. Torque 200 micro coulomb. Next 47. Now a conducting rod of length 4L is being rotated about O in a uniform magnetic field B. The conducting angular velocity omega as shown in figure. The potential difference between A and B. Clear? About this point, it is rotating. Right? They given like this. Okay? Above length given. This to this given length L, this to from O, center O, top A, bottom B. Now this is given 3L. Okay? What did we do? We have seen formula. When rod of length L is rotated above this point, we have seen that formula is, if this rod rotate like this, this will become, it look like this, okay, the path. This EMF is written as half B omega L square. But here it is not like that. The fixed vector is O. About this rotating, for this length, O is common point. For OB, B is common point. But here it is not like that. This is A. And this is B. About B it is rotating. So direct length is there. Okay, so AO acts like a one rod. Right? OB acts like another rod. So two induced EMF will develop. They are asking VA minus V. Right? Potential difference between A and B. Okay? Right, magnetic field. Clear? First, induced EMF E1 is equal to half B omega L. Right? Second one, half B omega L square is this, L square. This is what? 3 L square. So 9 L square. Right? They are asking potential difference between A and B, which is denominated E2. Clear? So how do we write potential difference? E2 minus E1. So half B omega 9 L square minus half B omega L square. What is common? Half B omega L square common, 9 minus 1. So half B omega L square 8. 2 ones, 2 fours. 4 B omega L square. Clear? Next, 48. Already we have done this question in an exercise problem, example problem, where it is example problem 17. Same question they repeated, and graph also they asked. You just follow 48 question. Which problem? Example problem 17. Okay, and 19 also. 49 also same question. Next, come to 50. In an inductor of inductance 5H, the current increases from 10 ampere to 20 ampere in 5 seconds. The average induced EMF. 50. Question 50. What did they give? L given. L is equal to L. L is equal to 5H. Di by dt given. Di by dt variation of the current. How many amperes per second? 20 final, 10 initial. So 20 minus 10 by, what is the time you use? 5 seconds. So this is 10 by 5. 10 by 10, 5 means 2 ampere per second. Then what they are asking? Induced EMF. E is equal to minus L di by dt. Minus L, what is the L value? 5. Di by dt, 2. So minus 10 volt. Next, 51. The current 2 ampere is increasing at a rate of 5 ampere per second through a coil of inductance H. The energy stored in inductor per unit time. Very interesting question. I is given. I is equal to 2 ampere. Rate of change of the current Di by dt is given as 5 ampere per second. This question is 51. What they are asking, L also given. L is given as how much? 4H. Then they are asking the energy stored per unit time is given by U is equal to half L I square. They are asking du by dt. So then this we will write half into L. I into 2I into di by dt. Differentiate with the time. Half. L is given 4. This is 2. I. These two, keep it as I is what? 2. Di by dt, 5. 1, 2, cancel. 2 into 4 into 2, 8, 8 into 5, 40. 40 joule per second. Okay. Next, we will go for 52. Next, 52. A purely inductive coil of inductance 2H is connected to a source of supply V is equal to 2D volt. The energy stored in the coil in 6 seconds. 52. Purely inductive coil of inductance L is equal to 2 Henry. Is connected source supply V is equal to 2G. Or E or V, whatever it is. The energy stored in the coil at 6 seconds. T is equal to T is equal to 6 seconds. U, they are asking. What is U formula? Energy stored in inductor half L I square. L already given. But we need to current. When T is equal to 6 seconds. Right? This how do we write? L is equal to L di by dt. So E is what? 2t is equal to L di by dt. Clear? So di is equal to 2t into dt by L. They are asking, we require current at 6 seconds. Integrate. 0 to 6 time. So this will be 2 by L is constant outside t dt, that is t square by 2. 0 to 6. Substitute the values. Then I is equal to, what is that? 2. L value is what? 2. 6 square. 36 by 2 minus 0. 2 to cancel. I is equal to 18. That substitute here. U is equal to half into L value 2 into 18 square. 2 to cancel. 18 square is the answer. What is 18 square value? 324. What is 18 square value? 324. Yeah. Interesting. Important question. They did not give current directly, they given potential. We calculated current at 6 seconds. That substituted in energy stored in a inductor form. Next, 53. So they given circuit. This is 10 ohm. Battery is there. And two inductors connected parallel. Again, 5 ohm resistor is there. This is Y. This is X. What did they ask? The network shown in the figure is a part of complete circuit. In a certain instant, current I is equal to ampere and it is increasing at a rate of 5 into 10 power 3 ampere per second. I is equal to how many amperes? It is 2 amperes. Di by dt given. It is increasing. So plus. So 5 into 10 power 3 ampere per second. Now, this what are these L values? L1 is equal to 3 milli Henry and L2 is equal to 18 milli Henry. Which combination this is? Parallel combination. Then this circuit will become 10 ohm and your battery, I did not write voltage, 4 volts. Parallel combination L1 L2 by L1 plus L2. 3 into 18 by 3 plus 18. 3 into 18 by 3 plus 18. This is 3 into 18 by 21. 7, 3 ones. 3, 7. If it is do like this, it is goes wrong. If cancellation is wrong. 21. 7. We don't get to, we'll check. Then this is 18 by 7. So this will become 18 by 7 milli Henry. Right? And 5 ohm. What? Current increasing means it acts like a battery life. Like this. If current decreasing means polarity changes. So this is 10 ohm as it is. 5 ohm as it is 4. This Y not 4. Current moving like this. Right? I is equal to 2 ampere. Now this is EMF already given 4 volts. This is 4 volts. This EMF is what? This how do we write? E is equal to L di by dt. L value is to 5 by, sorry, 18 by 7 into 10 power minus 3 into di by dt value. They mention where this 5 into 10 power 3, 5 into 10 power 3, 10 power 3, 10 power 3 cancel. This is 18 into 5, 18 into 5 is to 40, 90 by 7 volts. This is 90 by 7 volts. Okay, now follow. This is X, so Vx, current in same direction, so 2 into 10, 20 volts, leaving positive terminal, so plus 4. Leaving negative terminal minus 90 by 7, current in the path same direction minus, what is the current flowing? 10, is equal to V
Y.
V Y. They are asking what? V X minus V Y, V Y minus V X, V X minus V Y. Solve it, we will get the answer, but we will get wrong answer. Reason, this combination gives 18 by 7. It is not 18 by 7 actually. Okay, if we just take 3 and 9, what do we get? 3 and 9? 3 and 9, if we take it, 3 plus 9, this is 3 into 9 by 12. Also not good. Okay, there is something it is wrong.
7 is there, we don't get correct answer. Okay, so but what we followed is correct. Follow this method. Next, 54. Okay, 54 is when a current changed 5 ampere to 10 ampere in 2 seconds in a primary coil, induced EMF is in secondary coil is 25 volt. The mutual inductance is, okay, di by dt given,
di by dt.
Di by dt is what, 5 to 10 amperes in 2 seconds. So,
10 minus 5 by 2. This is 5 by 2 ampere per second.
Next, in the secondary coil, EMF is developed. E is equal to 25 volts. They are asking M. What is M formula? E is equal to, we are calculating only magnitude. So, M di by d. What they are asking? M they are asking. So, 25 is equal to M into 5 by 2. 5 ones, 5s. M is equal to 10 H. Okay, next, 55. A coil of radius R having n turns kept coaxially with the longer solenoid having n turns per unit length and radius capital R, the mutual inductance. Already we have done this. It's also there in the example problem. You check it. We will go for 6. Consider a long wire and a square loop as shown in figure. Mutual inductances. This is the important question. Here it is carries current I. Okay, and we have a rectangular frame here. This is A, and this length is L. This side length is also L. They are asking mutual inductance. How do you find mutual inductance? Flux linking this coil. Clear? Is directly proportional to current developed in this coil, right? So, how do we write B phi is equal to M into I? Clear? B produced by this conductor. B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi ln A by A, L by A. Already we have done this. Yes or no? Where it was there in the example problem. It is 7th one, in the page number 17, 7th one. Okay, ln 1 plus L by A. So this is formula B is 1 plus L by A. For a long wire, magnetic field produced in this region. Okay, into, sorry, it is B, this is phi, not B phi. Phi is flux linking with another coil. This is B A is equal to M I. Now we are calculating B A. B already magnetic field produced this current carrying conductor in this region. Formula already we have seen this one. So mu naught I 2 pi ln 1 plus L by A into area of this square, L square is equal to MI. This side R, same, what is there in M place? So M is equal to mu naught by 2 pi ln 1 plus L by A. Check this option. Mu naught L square, mu naught L square by 2 pi ln 1 plus L. Check it, 56. 56 they given option 4.
They missed L square. They missed L square. Why did they miss L? It's there in the B formula. By L is there. Let me check. L, why did they come? L square as. Okay, let me check. B is equal to mu naught I. But if you take your small portion here, small portion I taken, then what do you get? Current in this. This distance, let's say 2 pi. Okay, when a x distance, into we will have like this. So okay, this if we will do here, why it has come L instead of L square? Okay, this I have taken small portion here. This is, let us say, d x. Distance from the conductor is x. So, this area we need to take. Flux through this area I am taking as d phi. D phi is equal to mu in m into I. D phi how do we write? B into then dA. Okay, B is remains constant here. So area of the small area. This now this we try to calculate. So B into dA how do we write? Length into dx. Right? So this is, we are calculating d phi. Understand? So, d phi is equal to dl dx. We require total flux. So, then integrate. So, this phi is equal to bl constant, bl constant integration b dx. L into integration of b. B at this point is what? Mu naught I by 2 pi x. Dx. This dx varies from where to where? A to A plus A to A plus L. Now this you will get L as it is mu naught I by 2 pi x ln 1 by x dx ln. Substitute the upper limit and lower limit. What you get? L plus A plus L by A. Okay. Now we will get the correct answer. Now, these equations I am writing here. So, this is nothing but d phi. This is b d a. Okay, what did we get? Total flux. Flux is equal to, what did we get? Mu naught I L by 2 pi. This x will not come. We have done integration, then ln into a plus l by l. Then this we compare with m I or equate with m I. I place is there, what is there in m place? M is equal to mu naught l by 2 pi ln a plus r. This you simplify. What do you get? A by a plus l by a. So then this will be mu naught L by 2 pi ln 1 plus L by A. Now this is correct. Fourth option is now correct. We did wrong. This consideration we have done wrong. Anyway, we got correct answer now. 57. The given circuit. This is what? 18R. Okay, given circuit,
A given circuit, consider the circuit shown in the figure. The steady state current through the inductor of inductance 3L.
So they are asking current in this 3L inductor. Clear?
First we need to do what general thing if you follow.
Which current will split in this 3L? I2 will split. So once we get I2, we can get current split in 3L. How do you write? The current split in this, if you take it, let us say this is I3 and I4. So I3, how do you write? I3 is the 3L, current in 3L. How do you write? This inductor 6L by 3L plus 6L into I. Total current in this branch will be I. Understand? Now we need to find I2. Then how do you find I2? First we need to find total current. I is equal to E by R effective. Clear? E as it is, this is E. By this R and 6 are 9R. Here inductors will not have any resistance. So only 8R. 18R and 9R is parallel combination. Then R effective is equal to 9 into 18 by 9 plus 18. So 9 into 18 by 9 plus 18 is what? 27. 9 1 so 3 so 9. So this is E by 9. Are we correct or not? Then we need to I2. Then I2, I2, how do you decide? I2 is equal to this resistance. 9 by 3 into 6, 3 plus 6, 9R by, what is that? 9 plus 18 into total current I. So this will be 9 by 27 into E by 9 E by 27. This is I2 current. Substitute here. 6L by 9L into E by 27. LL cancel.
Check. 9R, RR, so R is there. This is R, this is R. So, this is also R. If cancellation is possible, check. What is that? This is. Well, first we will check the option and we will see option 3. Option 3 means E by 27R. E by 27R means what? These two will be cancelled. E by 27. Yeah, this solution is very simple. I made it complicated. These are all not required. Okay? So this is only required, right? Very simple solution. I made it complicated. I also not required. Then I3 is the current through the 3L. Right? This already we have done in the previous problem. We require I2. I2 is equal. Which combination? This is parallel combination. E is parallel at this point and at this point. Then I2 is equal. How do we write? E by 18 R. Then I3 is equal to 9L, sorry, 6L by 9L into E by 18 R. LL cancel, 6 ones, 6 threes, E by 27 R. Now option 3 is correct. Clear? I made it understand, I calculated, that's not required. Clear? Okay, now E by 27. Now 58. 58, they given time constant, they asked, that's not required. And 59. Consider the following circuit shown in figure T is equal to 0, switch is S closed. Then the current supply by T is equal to 0 at T is equal to infinity. This is also not required. And consider the following at T is equal to 0. This is also not required. 61 also not required. 62. 62 is the last problem. And 63 is LC oscillations that you will see in the next lesson. AC currents. 58, 59, 60. You read the table of form. You will get the answer. If you have a doubt, I will explain, no problem. Then 62. 62 also it's related to which one? Alternating currents also. But energy concept is there, we will try to solve this. In a following LC circuit, the switch S is closed. At T is equal to 0, the charge on capacitor T is equal to 0 is Q0. When T is equal to 0,
What is the charge on the capacitor? Q is equal to Q naught. This is a 62 coulomb solution. Then Q naught charge is there. There will be energy in a capacitor. What is the energy in capacitor in terms of Q? Energy stored in capacitor U is equal to half C V square. But we require in terms of charge. Q is equal to C V. Eliminate V. V is equal to Q by C. So this is 1 by 2 C into Q naught square by C square 1 C cancel. Then the energy stored in capacitor will be half into Q naught square by C initially. Then the chain, the charge of the circuit capacitor when the ratio of the energy in a electric and magnetic field is 1:3. So inductor connected. Initially the energy in this is what? Half Q naught square by C. What is the energy in the this is magnetic field, this is zero, this is electric field, right? What did they ask? The change in, what is the charge on the capacitor when the ratio of energy stored in electric and magnetic field is 1:3. So UE, UB is equal to 1/3. Okay, means 1:3 means here energy will be 1/4, here energy will be 3/4. Clear? If you take this ratio, you will get 1:3. Means what happened? So 3/4 of energy, electric energy converted into magnetic energy. What is the remaining energy? 1/4. Clear? So U by 4 is equal to, what is that? 1/2, new charge is Q square by C. What is the old charge? 1/2 Q naught square by C. So this I can write 1/2 into Q naught square by C total by 4. Or this I can write. This I will write here. U is what? 1 as it is. Q naught square as it is by 4 into 2. C is equal to 1/2 Q square by C. 2 cancel. CC cancel. So Q square is equal to Q naught square by 4. Then Q is equal to Q by 4. Because under root of Q naught square by 4. Root of Q naught square is Q naught. Root of 4 is 2. 2, 1, 1 clearly. Then under root of Q naught square by 4. This is root Q naught square. Q naught. Root 4. 2. What is the charge on capacitor? Q naught by 2. See, very interesting here. They given energy ratio 1:3. From this, we calculated the energy stored after some time is 1/4 on capacitor, 3/4 on inductor. So, this is the initial energy. Initial energy become 1/4. So U by 4 is equal to 1/2 Q square by C. This is the remaining energy. Remaining energy means which charge Q. Then we final after this, this was the charge. Clear? So this was U by 4 is equal to 1/2 Q square by C. For this energy, charge is this one. U by 4th energy, charge is Q. Right? What is U initial energy? That we substituted. We got charge on a capacitor when the energy will be 1/4. That is Q naught by 2. So option is second one. With this, we have finished electromagnetic induction level 1. Level 2 you practice. Almost same questions are there. If you have a doubt, immediately you can ask. Still nobody asking doubts. There are few, I can say 1 and 2 are asking. That also very simple questions. So this means what? You are not reading textbook properly. You are not doing material properly. We have a time. So practice. Don't waste the time. Clear. And also prepare question and answers also. Right. We'll meet in the next class.